Well, ever since the Balakot airstrike, there has been a sense that the opposition will have to try and play their game differently, since national security and nationalism are two planks on which Mr. Modi is seen as having the advantage. So Mamata Banerjee, Sharad Pawar and Chandrababu Naidu have been trying hard to get the Congress in particular to rework possible alliances, like with the Aam Aadmi Party in Delhi, for example. However, that pretty much collapsed today after the Delhi Congress said that it was unwilling to play ball, leading to this angry outburst from AAP chief Arvind Kejriwal, who accused the Congress of helping the BJP. The AAP, which had announced six candidates for Delhi's seven Lok Sabha seats last week, had indicated that it was open for negotiations. In fact, Mr. Kejriwal had earlier said that the Congress was unwilling to ally with his party in Delhi and that he was fed up of reaching out to them.
क्या हमें गठबंधन करना चाहिए नहीं तो unanimous decision यही हुआ कि गठबंधन नहीं होगा.
तो मैम ये आप लोगों का ये यही है decision कि आप गठबंधन नहीं.
राहुल जी ने थे वहाँ पे, राहुल जी के सामने ये decision हुआ तो it's final.
It's a final that there will be no alliance.
No, no.
And मैम और कोई candidates के नाम या कुछ भी और कोई discuss हुआ है अभी तक?
पिछले कई दिनों से कांग्रेस पार्टी जिस तरह के लुका छिपी का खेल खेल रही थी, आज कांग्रेस ने दिल्ली के अंदर ऐलान किया है कि आम आदमी पार्टी के साथ गठबंधन नहीं होगा. ऐलान तो ये किया है, लेकिन इससे ये बात स्पष्ट हो गई है कि दिल्ली के अंदर ही नहीं, देश के अंदर देश की जनभावनाओं के खिलाफ जाकर के स्वतंत्र उम्मीदवार उतारने की जिद पर अड़ी है. वो इस बात को दर्शाता है कि कहीं ऐसा तो नहीं है कि कांग्रेस का भारतीय जनता पार्टी के साथ अघोषित अलायंस हो गया.
Well, joining us tonight, Raghav Chadha of the Aam Aadmi Party, Priyanka Chaturvedi of the Congress Party, Mr. Mahesh Verma, leader of the BJP, and senior journalist Aarti Jairath is with us today. Raghav Chadha, just, you know, take us through this. I mean, is this the end of any discussion at all with the Congress, or is there a window open somewhere? Because generally, you never say never in Indian politics, or is it over?
Well, first of all, Nidhi, let me be very clear. There hasn't been any formal discussion between the two parties. There is no doubt in the fact that the Aam Aadmi Party and various other opposition parties were of the view that we need to put up one candidate against the BJP's candidate in order to ensure that the anti-BJP vote does not get split. And it was with that in mind that the Aam Aadmi Party was contemplating something of that sort. As far as the Congress's position is concerned, Congress has been dilly-dallying, and this time around the Congress, which perhaps lives under a rock, does not understand the mood of the nation, has now decided to go solo as far as politics of Delhi is concerned. And that leads us to only one conclusion, that in UP, the Congress is fighting the SP-BSP alliance, thereby benefiting the BJP. In Bengal, the Congress is fighting the Trinamool Congress, thereby benefiting the BJP. And in Delhi, the Congress is fighting the Aam Aadmi Party and thereby benefiting the BJP. So therefore, it appears that Congress has no understanding of the mood of the nation, and they actually want that the anti-BJP vote should be split. As far as the position of the Aam Aadmi Party is concerned, it was the Congress party that complained against 21 legislators of Aam Aadmi Party that got disqualified. It was the Congress that rushes to the Lieutenant Governor every time the Cabinet of Delhi passes any judgment, any decisions so that the decision can be revoked. It is the Congress that claps whenever any of our MLAs gets booked under any fabricated cases. But leaving all that aside, leaving aside all that animosity, the Aam Aadmi Party was open to putting up one candidate against the BJP. It is the Aam Aadmi Party that supported the Puducherry Chief Minister of Congress. It is the Aam Aadmi Party that supported the presidential and the vice presidential candidate of the Congress. Unsolicited support was extended. And it was the Aam Aadmi Party that stood with the Congress and various other political parties when unconstitutionally two governments, one of Uttarakhand and one of Arunachal Pradesh of the Congress party, were dismissed at the whims and fancies of the Modi government, because Arvind Kejriwal and Aam Aadmi Party believe that Modi and Amit Shah are anti-democratic. The country is in danger. The democracy and India's constitution is in danger.
Okay.
And we need to save this country We need to save the democracy.
Let me just get a comment from Priyanka on this.
And it was in that interest, it was in that context that we said
Okay, so we're talking in past tense. Priyanka Chaturvedi, how does the Congress see this attack by Arvind Kejriwal? I mean, he's basically saying that there is a Congress-BJP alliance. Never thought I'd hear those words in my lifetime. But anyway, how would you respond to that?
So firstly, I'd like to respond, there is absolutely no confusion as far as the Congress party is concerned, whether it is in Delhi, whether it is in Punjab. We are very clear as to who our alliance partners would be. Alliance would not be on the basis of opportunism, but would be on the basis of ideological connection with every single party. I'm very surprised that he brings out the TMC, he brings out the Samajwadi party. On a day when Akhilesh Yadav has gone on record to say that we continue to be in an alliance with the Congress. I don't know why these questions keep being asked of the Congress party or for that matter the Samajwadi party. The question here, the moot point here is that here is a political party which started as an anti-corruption movement with the total support of Rashtriya Swayam Sevak Sangh, goes on to become a political party with the total help. And if you go onto their website, if you go back in history, their website categorically said Modi for PM, Arvind for CM. So party which has gone on record to support the Bharatiya Janata Party has always tried to change the narrative whenever the Bharatiya Janata Party is being cornered on issues of corruption, on issues of governance, on issues of women's rights, on issues of farmer rights, on issues
sure,
of Dalit
Priyanka,
movement.
Sure, you're right.
On
but the point
of,
is, the point is that
other,
everybody
you know,
knows that if please, the Congress and the AAP don't come together
to
in Delhi,
the
it's advantage
BJP.
You, if the Congress and the AAP don't come together in Delhi,
no,
everyone knows that that helps the BJP.
Absolutely not. Absolutely
so,
not.
How?
You know, this is, Nidhi, this is a narrative that was pushed around even in the Punjab elections. I have been on debates on NDTV with all due apologies to you, on NewsX and various other channels which said the Aam Aadmi Party is getting a walkover on Congress Party in Punjab because we did not get into an alliance or we did not fight together.
May I respond
but
to this,
Congress
briefly?
Proved it otherwise. In the same context, I would say if Aam Aadmi Party is so concerned about the constitution and so concerned about democracy, then maybe they should withdraw all their candidates and allow the Congress to contest all the seats. And perhaps we will give them a good
but
reason to cheer.
But why would they? They won 67
the
seats.
Party,
they won 67 seats last time. Okay, very quick
norms.
Quick rebuttal from Raghav and then I'll come to Aarti.
They were 67 last time. You know, every single day is a new day in politics.
So but
please,
there is a benchmark
say,
no, on which they can demand
to get
certain seats. Okay,
does
Raghav.
Does mean they have the same support even now?
Raghav.
Benchmark is not...
If you all can't get along on a TV debate, I don't know what's happening behind the scenes. Raghav.
As far as this allegation is concerned, that AAP has anything to do with the RSS, I think it doesn't even merit a response. It is a stupid allegation, and if that were the case, then why did the Congress give outside support to the Aam Aadmi Party government in 2013? If they firmly believe and have come to a conclusion that we are or we were supported by RSS, I think it's an obnoxious claim that does not even merit a response. As far as Punjab is concerned, anybody who studies or has studied the Punjab politics,
we don't need a response.
And in particular the 2017 Legislative Assembly election would tell you. Anybody would tell you that the votes of the BJP were transferred to the Congress party in Punjab with clinical precision. It was Dr. Roy of NDTV who did a survey few days before the election and said that the Aam Aadmi Party is winning with an overwhelming two-third majority. That did not happen because
yes,
the BJP transferred its
us.
Vote to the Congress party with clinical precision to ensure that the Aam Aadmi Party
Mr.
does not win. And therefore I say this, I am not saying that AAP and BJP have an alliance, but all I am saying
what
is that
the
I did not interrupt when you were speaking.
I'm sorry.
Okay, one second,
permit
one second.
Me
your
to
words, Raghav,
permit me to finish.
Quickly finish that point. I have to. Because the BJP is smiling here next to me watching this.
This is absolutely incorrect and untrue.
The Congress, now stop. You see, she needs to stop. This needs to stop.
No, they
the Congress,
you're saying that
they're
indirectly helping the BJP.
To defeat a force called the Aam Aadmi Party time and again. And in Delhi also, they're doing the exact same thing.
Both of them know has been the
that
B-team
if they fight solo, it's advantage BJP. And they are doing
opposition
that.
Right, unity just went for a toss.
To ensuring that they help RSS and the BJP.
Guys.
That the Congress is returning the favor to the BJP.
Who's coming as a spokesperson of a party where he said he's willing to resign if
the Congress
Party
is returning the favor to the BJP.
Punjab,
the BJP was favored.
And is also a candidate for Aadmi Party.
Okay, Okay, Priyanka, 1 second. Let me get Aarti into this.
If Dr. Roy of NDTV predicted and everyone else, every pollster in this country predicted that we're winning, we lost because you guys cheated the people of Punjab.
Please talk about your resignation.
You guys
took support from the
BJP.
Time out, please. Okay, one second. Let me just get Aarti Jairath here because this is reflective of a bigger problem then, right?
No, maybe if, I don't know. But no, what I know is that we formed the government.
Okay,
Aarti. You spoke about resigning.
Okay, Priyanka, I'll come back to you. I've got two more panelists here. You know, if, for instance, this is sort of unraveling the way that it is in Delhi, we know that Sharad Pawar, Mamata Banerjee, by the way, has been the one who's been really pushing Arvind Kejriwal and the Congress to get together. Then you have this sort of attempt, you know, in Bengal as well. Sitaram Yechuri spoke about having an understanding on some seats. You get a sense that, you know, at least these three leaders are kind of like saying, guys, wake up, smell the coffee, Balakot has happened, it's giving Mr. Modi an advantage.
Yes.
But the Congress is not seeing that.
Absolutely. And I think, you know, Nidhi, there is no question. The onus for a united opposition fight against Modi rests with the Congress. The Congress is the bigger party, and the fact is, bigger party in the sense it has a larger national spread. These are all regional parties. But these regional parties are much more grounded, and in their states, they are really strong. So if you want to bring the entire opposition together on one platform, I mean, I think the Congress has to recognize that these regional parties have strength where they're in their states, and it has to make way for them. It has to be more large-hearted. It has to embrace the alliance in a much more open and generous manner. Otherwise, there's no way there's going to be a united opposition fight. And then it's very clearly advantage BJP, as we can see from the smile on his face.
You're watching all this. Do you feel that, in a sense, the opposition is losing the narrative post-Balakot?
देखिए एक आपको मैं बात बताना चाहूँगा. सबसे पहले तो मैं ये राघव चड्ढा जी की जो बात थी इसके ऊपर मैं कुछ कहना चाहूँगा कि अगर केजरीवाल जी के उस कसम को आप ध्यान करें जिसमें उन्होंने अपने बच्चों की कसम उठाई और कहा कि भाई मैं अपनी बच्चों की कसम खाता हूँ कि मैं कांग्रेस से कभी अलायंस नहीं करूँगा, और आज वही व्यक्ति अगर इस चीज़ के लिए ये कह रहे हैं कि कांग्रेस अलायंस ना करके एक बहुत बड़ी राजनीतिक भूल कर रही है, और उस भूल का नतीजा पंजाब भी है जहां पर आपके जो इलेक्शन का जो एग्जिट पोल था या ओपिनियन पोल था उसमें जो है कहीं आम आदमी पार्टी जीतती हुई नज़र आ रही थी, और डिवीजन ऑफ वोट की वजह से ये जो परिणाम पंजाब में मिला. तो ऐसा सोच कर ये जो बात रख रहे हैं, मुझे लग रहा है कि ये केजरीवाल जी की एक राजनीतिक चलाकी, एक जो पॉलिटिकल उनका एक और जिमिक जो है ना सामने आया है कि एक आदमी कसम उठाता है और कसम उठा के और फिर कहता है कि मैं कांग्रेस से गठबंधन के लिए तैयार हूं, तो उसके पीछे एक ही मंशा मुझे समझ में आती है, वो ये कि ये 7 सीट पर लोकसभा की अगर 7 सीट जीत भी लेते हैं केजरीवाल साहब भाई दीबे, तो उसका कोई फायदा उनको होने वाला नहीं है. तो वो हर हाल में चाहेंगे कि कांग्रेस से हमारा गठबंधन हो ताकि हम विधानसभा में अपने उस वोट को शिफ्ट करें जो वोट शिफ्ट हो चुका था, जो डिवीजन ऑफ वोट की वजह से हमने
बात कही कि उन्होंने करप्शन, उन्होंने कांग्रेस, यू नो, दे वर अटैकिंग द कांग्रेस ऑन करप्शन. ये सवाल मैंने अरविंद केजरीवाल से भी पूछा था, लेकिन आपको पता है पॉलिटिक्स में क्या होता है. बीजेपी और पीडीपी की अलायंस किसने सोची थी, हुई ना.
देखिए
तो कांग्रेस और आपकी क्यों नहीं हो सकती.
हाँ, मैं वही, कांग्रेस और आपकी, अभी यहाँ एक चीज समझने की जरूरत है कि केजरीवाल जी की एक मजबूरी है. मजबूरी क्या है कि उनका वोट, केजरीवाल का वोट और कांग्रेस का वोट लगभग एक सा है. अगर कांग्रेस से आज अलायंस होता है तो कांग्रेस का वोट शिफ्ट होगा आम आदमी पार्टी की तरफ, ये आप तय मानिए.
Exactly.
और ये जो लोकसभा चुनाव है इसमें अगर वो शिफ्ट करने में कामयाब हो जाते हैं तो विधानसभा उनके लिए बहुत आसान हो जाएगा. तो ये केजरीवाल की एक राजनीतिक रूप से एक चलाकी कही जाएगी जिसकी वजह से वो कांग्रेस के साथ गठबंधन.
Okay,
और इस बात को शीला जी अच्छी तरह से समझती हैं क्योंकि जो आदमी शीला जी के खिलाफ 23 करप्शन का केस जो है खोला हो, 23 फाइलें बनाई हो, अनऑथराइज कॉलोनी, दिल्ली जल बोर्ड घोटाला, वैसे आदमी के मुंह से आज ये बात सुनना.
अच्छा, महेश
कि भाई कांग्रेस से गठबंधन करना हमारे लिए
earlier,
देश हित में होगा.
आई स्पोक अर्लियर टू सीताराम येचुरी ऑफ द सीपीएम बिकॉज एज आई सेड मिस्टर येचुरी आल्सो टॉक्ड अबाउट यू नो द पॉसिबिलिटी ऑफ अ सीट एडजस्टमेंट इन 6 सीट्स इन बंगाल विद द कांग्रेस. And Mr. Yechury, has there really been a shift in the way the opposition is looking at alliances after the Balakot airstrike?
Well, first of all, Balakot has been our Air Force, Indian Air Force has done a very courageous act going deep into territory of Pakistan, attacking the terrorist base. And for that, all of us are proud of that. And this is the fight between United India and terrorism. Now, this United India's unity is being disrupted by the Prime Minister and the government by seeking to pit this as a fight against Kashmiris, against Muslims, and convert this into a partisan fight as though the government and the BJP is the one conducting the fight, hiding behind the courage of our soldiers and our army men, and trying to portray the entire opposition as being opposed to this. There can be nothing farther away from the truth. They are rousing jingoistic nationalism, hoping to gain electorally and politically. This won't be allowed by the Indian people. And the reason I say this won't be allowed by the Indian people is, one, they see through this charade. Number two, that the Indian people in these elections will decide on what is their day-to-day living conditions. Have they improved or they deteriorated? That is going to be the main issue on which people will vote.
Well, you know, you've talked about an understanding with the Congress in 6 seats in Bengal, Mr. Yechury. Now, is that final or are you going to be meeting Rahul Gandhi first? What's the Congress's response been?
No, we have made our offer. It's for them to respond. We are saying that we are sincere in our commitment to fight and make sure that the BJP does not return to government at the center, and we'll fight to save Bengal from the Trinamool Congress. Our objective is to maximize the anti-BJP, anti-Trinamool votes in Bengal, for which this is the first step that we have taken in the direction in order to ensure such maximization takes place. Now it's up to the Congress to respond. And our message is clear to the people of Bengal and to everybody else.
And how would this work, given that there is also talk then of an understanding between the Trinamool Congress and the Congress as well in about 4 or 5 seats in Bengal?
Well, that's what these are the questions that the Congress will have to answer, no? I mean, it's not us. Our objective is clear. And I think the people's objective in Bengal is also clear. And the Congress in Bengal has been talking in those terms that they are opposed to both BJP and the TMC. For them now to take the final call.
Well, finally, Mr. Yechury, in a sense, as we've been saying, alliances have become more important again after Balakot and the perception that the BJP is making gains through this campaign. How do you see then, for instance, the way the AAP Congress tie-up is playing out and the way that seems to be collapsing? Because it doesn't then portend very well for the opposition, does it?
Well, you see, please understand, politics is not arithmetic. It is not adding up 2 and 2 that makes 4 in arithmetic. 2 and 2 can make 22 in politics, or it can also lead to a 0. So don't equate this or reduce this to pure arithmetic calculations. But I think politically, if you look at it, the people's response is going to be, I repeat, on the status of their livelihood, which is sharply deteriorated. We have the worst economic slowdown in decades that has happened now. We have the highest levels of unemployment. We have the highest levels of farmer suicides and the agrarian distress. If the farmer, the youth and the worker in our country are dissatisfied, whatever amount of jingoism that we want to rouse, that is not going to really result, convert into any electoral dividend.
All right, Mr. Yechury, thank you very much for joining us. And Let me get quick last comments from the panel then on what he said, and Aarti Jairath first. You know, this actually is looking like that the opposition, frankly, after Balakot, which they kind of went silent, is looking sort of even more chaotic, to be honest. I mean, how is this going to work?
No, I mean, Nidhi, quite clearly after Pulwama and then the Balakot airstrikes, I think the PM and the BJP have been dominating the narrative. There's no question about it. And the opposition is looking very confused because they don't know how to respond to this very, you know, hyped up nationalism that the BJP is now propagating. They don't seem, and you know, they had a plank earlier, if you remember. It was the opposition that was controlling the narrative, talking about jobs, talking about rural distress.
No one's talking about jobs anymore.
No one's talking about jobs anymore.
At least on TV.
And even in their public statements, the opposition, particularly senior Congress leaders, are getting trapped into a debate with the BJP on what did you do in Balakot? Did anybody really die? Did you achieve anything? I mean, do they want to fight the BJP on its own terrain?
Does the Congress need to sort of take a step back and reflect on, you know, then how it is also dealing with regional parties, not just AAP, other parties as well?
So, Nidhi, all I'd like to mention here is alliances happen on ideological acceptance, not on the basis of opportunistic alliances, just because there's a Pulwama that has happened or Balakot that has happened. We cannot forget that we are also fighting for political space, and the Congress party is very committed to ensuring that the people of Delhi get the promises that were delivered to them. And if promises have not been delivered, we are bound to question the government of the day. It's not just about Aam Aadmi Party. All our alliances are going to be based on the basis of ideology rather than opportunism. We are not going to be a BJP which ties up with a PDP or a Shiv Sena in Maharashtra just to hold on to power.
Okay, so Raghav, quick response. Issues that concern, are you seeking an opportunistic alliance to defeat Modi?
Whether it is about the economy,
I've got 30 seconds, Priyanka. Let me get Raghav to quickly respond to that. Raghav, 30 seconds.
Nidhi, the Aam Aadmi Party that has 67 out of 70 seats in the Legislative Assembly of Delhi, Aam Aadmi Party that has performed extremely well over the last four elections in Delhi, is willing to put up one candidate against the BJP's candidate because we put the country, nation first before the party, and we say that what really needs to be done right now is that democracy of India needs to be saved from the BJP, the institution of this country need to be saved. The Constitution of India needs to be saved. Unlike the Congress, which is willing to seek its own revival, to find some political relevance in Delhi at the cost of having Modi and Amit Shah come to power again, I think it's very clear that we are serious about defeating the BJP.
We'll have to see now. We'll have to see now whether the Raghav, I'm completely out of time. I'm very sorry. I have to take a break. I have to take a break, guys. I don't know if we've heard the last word just yet on AAP and the Congress. At the moment, it appears the doors are closed. But we've seen in Indian politics time and again that you know, you never say never. Let's see what happens. See you again tomorrow. Goodbye.